I can't live without the beat. Go build, come on, build. I'ma break it down right now, build. Big boy, big sound, build. Break it down right now, build. I'ma break it down, build. I'ma break it down, build. I'ma break it down right now, boom. Freestyle on the beat now, build. Break it down right now, boom. If it mean out, if it mean out, beat.
I, as a convener of this seminar, and on my own behalf, welcome you all to this land of enlightenment and salvation. Respected Chairperson, Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor Rathor Sir, Chief Guest Professor Arvind Jam Khedkar Ji, Guest of Honor Sriyut Swant Ranjan Ji, Resource Person, Dean Student Welfare, Chief Proctor, Dean School of Social Sciences Professor Bhaumik, Deans of different schools, heads of different departments, librarian, faculty members, delegates. It is indeed a matter of honor for the Department of Sociological Studies and Department of Historical Studies to host this 2 days national seminar. We have with us Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor Rathor Sir to preside over this inaugural session and deliver the presidential address. We are honored by your presence, sir, and I am grateful for your kind benevolence and support. It is utterly beyond my ability to acquire appropriate words for expressing my gratitude towards you, sir. You have always been a constant source of help for us. This seminar owes much to your guidance, support, and painstaking comments at every step. I also cordially welcome Chief Guest Professor Arvind Jam Khedkar Ji and Guest of Honor Sriyut Swant Ranjan Ji. We are fortunate to have you here, sir. All of us are aware of your high stature and the highest standard of scholarship. We are really grateful and indebted for accepting your invitation, and you are here in this morning with us. We have invited many scholars of repute from different parts of Indian universities. May I now welcome all the resource persons. They have accepted our invitations and they will be part of our plenary session. I also welcome Dean Student Welfare, Chief Proctor, faculty members, resource person, participants and other delegates and students. I am delighted to announce that we have received more than 100 participants in this seminar. They are from different backgrounds of sociology and history. This is an opportune moment for us to welcome all the delegates of this seminar who have come from different parts. The Department of Sociological Studies and Department of Historical Studies jointly organizing this seminar is indicative of the fact that history and sociology are very close to each other. History is considered as present sociology. History is past sociology and sociology is present history. For historians, rewriting history is act. It is a way history as a mode of knowledge develops. As the perspectives change, scholars look at the past in new ways, reinterpret events, discover new meanings within them. Rewriting history is by itself neither good nor bad. Everything depends on the spirit in which historical evidence is approached, and accordingly its social consequences are realized. Those who rewrite history sometimes face dilemma between their scholarly demand and their inclination towards particular ideology or particular other associations. Sometimes they face dilemma. Their dilemma is, it seems, same the types of dilemma was faced by Duryodhan. Here I am remembering one of the references of Mahabharata, when Lord Krishna asked Duryodhan that despite you are having wonderful lineage, you are having wonderful guru, why do you behave in this way? He narrated his dilemma and said, Janami dharma na cha me pravrittihi, janamya dharma na cha me nivrittihi. I know what is dharma, but I cannot attach myself to the dharma. At the same time, I know what is adharma, but I cannot detach from myself from the adharma. The way rewriting history has special social consequences, the same is there when we reinterpret or misinterpret or interpret history according to our own perceptions. Normally, we are habituated of blaming others. Same is applicable here also. When we try to understand the history, sometimes we misinterpret it, and because of our own convenience, because of our own perceptions, we try to analyze in particular context and we blame it for rewriting history. And in this way, perhaps we commit the same mistakes like ek khata hum jindagi bhar karte rahe dhool chehre par thi aina hum saaf karte rahe. In this context, different sub-themes of the seminar is principally designed, and I do hope that you will find the deliberations of this seminar quite educative. Although every attempt has been made in preparation of this seminar, but to err is human. I am sure that you are generous enough to forgive us for the any deficiency which might have remained in making this seminar. Once again, I join my hands with all the members of this organizing committee to welcome you all to the Central University of South Bihar. Thanks all for your kind listening. Thank you. Jai.
Historical studies and archaeology and convener for his brief remark on the theme and perspective of the seminar.
Thank you. Honorable Vice Chancellor sir, chief guest, Honorable Chairman ICHR Professor Arvind P. Jamkhedkar sir, our guest of honor Sriman Swantranjan ji, my senior colleague Dr. Anil Kumar Singh jha, eminent scholars, officials of the university, respected deans, heads, faculty members, participants and dear students. It is indeed a great honor and privilege for me to have been called upon to introduce the theme of the national seminar. Needless to say that this is a great and very felicitous moment for all of us to host such a great academic event. Let me first express my grateful thanks to Honorable Vice Chancellor, under whose leadership it has become possible for us to host great academicians and intellectuals from across the country. I know my limitations as far introducing the subject is concerned, as there are a number of reputed and eminent scholars among us. It would be a great honor for all of us to listen to them on the subject. But nevertheless, following the traditions and procedures of the National Seminar, as a convener, I would very humbly like to introduce the theme. As we know, there has been a continuous debate regarding rewriting Indian history. Interestingly, the debate has been taking place in media and even on roads among those who are not systematically trained in the discipline. The real practitioners and the thinkers of the discipline have largely been silent. Therefore, the first and foremost purpose of this seminar is to provide a sound platform for the scholars and intellectuals to come together and deliberate over this relevant issue in true academic perspective. Now, first of all, we should think over the terms rewriting history itself. Whenever the terms come across, there is a hue and cry from certain sections that history is being changed. We forget the line between rewriting history and change of history. How can the facts established on the basis of sound sources and valid historical method be changed? How can the past be undone? So the debate is always misguided and misinformed, perhaps due to fear of the hegemony in the historical writing of certain sections being challenged. History depends upon the sources, and the sources are neither definitive nor fixed. There are always chances of coming across new sources in terms of their growing explorations and advancement of technologies and their use. In the lights of new sources,
there is always a scope of rewriting of history and contextualizing it in constantly changing socio-economic milieu. My point is that rewriting is inherent in the nature of history. We don't know the past as it was. We always try to explore and reconstruct the past, and it is a continuous process. It is not sacrilegious and infallible like religious texts. We should always welcome new sources and new interpretations to explore the past. It is the lifeline of history, otherwise it will cease to exist as a discipline. Yes, there is no gainsaying the fact that we must incorporate new sources following the approved procedure of historical inquiry in establishing the facts. For this, we should always keep in mind the instruction of the great Indian historian of early medieval period, Kalhan. Shraddhya Soeb Gunman Ragad Dvesh Bahiskrita Bhutartha Kathane Yasya Istheyasya Saraswati. Now the second aspect is that if rewriting history is epistemologically justified, then we should think over where and how rewriting is inevitable in Indian history. We know with regard to ancient period there is a lot of gaps and the available history is rather sketchy. Without a doubt, there is a need to fill the gaps and add more details. This period relates to times when Indians were way ahead of most of the world in terms of development, civilization, arts and crafts, knowledge and civil administration. So we must focus on this aspect. There are now new scientific sources available regarding the original homeland of the Aryans, which refute the British theory what we have been taught so far. This is an important question before us, that should we incorporate new sources or continue to accept the Macaulayan mode of thinking which has distorted the construction of our past largely. Similarly, there are examples of various facts and achievements of our past which have been missed purposely. For example, we read postmodernism and theories of Derrida and Foucault, who had been influenced by the linguistic theory of Ferdinand de Saussure. But it is important to know that the linguistic theory of Saussure was borrowed from the theory of Apohavad of Acharya Dinganaga of ancient period. He said, Agau Nishedah Iti Gavayah, and by it he explained that there is no essential relationship between words and objects, the core of the postmodernistic philosophy. But unfortunately, we don't know about Dinganaga and do not find his place in history of ideas. Similarly, the postmodernistic theory of meaning, that it is dependent not upon text but context, is largely influenced by the Jain philosophy of Syadvad. Syad asti, syad nasti, syad asti cha, syad nasti cha, syad asti cha avaktavyam, syad nasti cha avaktavyam, it is. In historical research method, we are taught deductive and inductive method, but we forget the panchavayav anuman, pratigyas, hetu, udaharan, upaman, praman. Panchavayav anuman of Nyaya school of thought of ancient period. What I want to point out that a number of achievements of our ancient past have been missing. Should not there be an attempt to portray these achievements in order to build up Indian knowledge system rather than accepting the borrowed and mechanical perception of our past? In medieval period, there has been a great deliberations over the periods of Delhi Sultanate and the Mughals. But does it reflect the whole medieval Indian history of India, medieval history of India? For example, Ahom dynasty ruled interrupted for nearly six centuries from 1228 to 1826 AD, but we hardly find its mention in our books and syllabi. The rule of the Cholas, Pandyas, Chalukyas and Vijayanagar has largely been ignored. Should not we think over it in order to portray a real picture of our medieval past? In modern period, there has been an attempt to convert the national freedom struggle into biographies of some selected leaders. Some deserving events and names have been purposely missed out, while a few have been given more than what was actually due to them. Sacrifices of many commoners, tribals, Dalits have been largely lost sight of. If a collective identity of an Indian nation is to be built, we have to remember the collective sacrifices of all and give them due respect. There are a number of questions which require immediate attention of the scholars.
Now it is time to throw light on the most important and innovative aspect of the theme, that is relation between history writing and society. Apart from the interdisciplinary approach, there are important questions as well. Is history writing only a mental exercise? If not, then this should be our priority, to think over that how history and society influence each other. How can the real social problems be solved through historical investigation? How history and history writing can contribute to building up of an enriched, egalitarian and informed society? How the real social challenges like casteism, communalism and separatism be mitigated through understanding their deep-rooted causes and evolution by historical investigation? And ultimately, how history writing can contribute to the development of the sense of patriotism and nationalism among the common masses? So these are the questions and objectives before us to think over, and the outcome of which will define the success of this seminar. Let us come together and let us think together with great Indian tradition, Ano Bhadraha Kratubo Yantu Vishwataha, let the noble thoughts come to us from all sides. Thank you very much.